Welcome, Prasiyas, once again. In the explanation of nonverbal data, where we have to get the explanation of roadmap. I hope till now in your life, at once at least you try to explain your location of your house to any of your relatives, friends, or anybody, or else to Amazon delivery persons or to Flipkart delivery persons. You must have at least try to locate your house, and for that purpose you must have given certain signboards. You must have remember, or you told them take this left, right, or something like that for Swiggy delivery as well. So this is actually how we normally give oral instructions. In that way we have this roadmap to be drawn. In the examination they will give you one of the a written text for that, like where they give you certain directions and you have to create a roadmap, or roadmap will be given, you have to interpret that roadmap in the whatever the directions they have said, they have actually drawn, you have to interpret that in a proper way. So now we'll read out how to check the roadmap when you are drawing the roadmap, and where could be your left and where could be your right. So here is that I have drawn one roadmap for you. When you draw the roadmap, think that you are here. You are here, your face is at this side, facing towards this side. You are walking in this direction. So obviously, if you are standing here, your left could be this side and right could be this side. This is left, this is right. So whenever you are drawing this roadmap, imagine it out yourself facing towards the direction being given. So here you are standing. Okay, when you are going from this side, then what you are finding here, this is a four way, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is the crossroads. Then you are walking again towards a particular place known as T junction. This is looking like T. From here to here, you can see this. This is the T junction. Then after crossing, obviously the route is not there. So you are going from this side, and then what you are finding here is the Y junction. This is looking like a Y junction. I have written over here. And you have to mark here a certain place which is being mentioned in the question. Gandhi statue. Sometimes they give hospital or hostel building or any company's name. So you have to, according to the instruction, you have to write down over there, and a little bit mark could be given, like a small box or something to be drawn, and the name of the particular building which they have mentioned in the question to be written down. And opposite to that is the house. So this is the direction actually being given to show the location of the house of the person who is the narrator. Okay, so like you are showing your house to a certain person. So how do you show that? From the bus stop it starts. Okay, now we'll read the text, then I'll continuously explain you this and that together. Okay, take the road from the bus stop. Okay, take the road from the bus stop. Imagine it out, bus stop could be here. Take the road from the bus stop. Go straight from the crossroads. This is, as I said, crossroads. So go straight from the crossroads till you reach T junction. Till you reach T junction. Take a right turn, because as I said, if you are standing here, your left could be this side, your right could be this side. Take a right turn. Then after a few yards, this yards you are walking or on the bike or anything, take the first left. Take the first left. This is your left side. Then go straight till you find Y junction. Go straight. That means after walking few yards, you find, or 100 meters, 50 meters, whatever it may be, you can write down. It's overall, imaginary route map and imaginary situation. So there is no hard and fast rule that you have to write down only 100 meters. You can write down 10 meters, 20 meters, as much as you want. Okay. So you can say like that, till you find the Y junction, then you have to walk over there, then take a right turn. When you are standing here, are you taking a right turn or left turn? Obviously, you have to take the right turn. Take a right turn, you will see Gandhi statue on your left, because you are going this side, your left could be this side. Okay, so Gandhi statue would be on your left. Opposite to that is my house. Opposite to that is my house. Opposite to that means opposite to Gandhi statue is my house. Okay. This way you are explaining the route map to the other person. While drawing the route map, you have to keep it in mind all these instructions. Take the road from the bus stop. This is the road taken. Go straight from the crossroads. This is the crossroads you have to draw. Then go straight. Take a right turn. This is your right turn. After a few yards, take the first left. Few yards, then first left. Go straight till you find the Y junction. After finding the Y junction, you have to do what? You have to take the right turn. In the right turn, at your left side, you find Gandhi statue, and opposite to that is my house. So you have to imagine yourself standing here, facing towards the junctions and the crossroads, or the overall destination. Then while getting that, you can get easily the idea that when you are standing this side, obviously your left falls this side and the right could be this category. So here, after seeing this, you have to write down this, or after reading this, you have to draw this. This is the route map. Many route maps are there being given in your study material as well as your reader. This is exercise 1 from your textbook, which I have given it to you. You can do many as a part of practice, and whatever being instructed into the question, draw that only. Don't add extra things from your side, because there is no need. They wanted only those things which is being mentioned in the question. Rather than doing from your own, it's better to follow the instructions. If in the question, if the text be being given like this, you have to draw the route diagram. So while drawing the route diagram, make it or draw it with the pencil first. Draw it with the pencil slowly in neat and a legible manner. Write down everything, and for the church, mosque, because they'll give you like that. Instead of Gandhi statue, if they give church and mosque and all, so don't put any religious symbols over there. There is no need for the religious symbols. Only put a small box like that, or a rectangle or a square something, then you can move on to that. There is no need for you to draw all the things. Okay, so take care of these things while drawing the route map. This is not difficult if you understand it properly, as I have given you all these, the directions and all, by seeing, imagining yourself at the place. Then you can do it in a better way. So I hope you have understood. With this, we have completed all the information transfer. We have done all the diagrams, from bar graph to table, then flow chart, then you have pie diagram, then your this one route map. We have done everything. Tree diagram also being explained and drawn. All the diagrams with their non-verbal format as well as the text format or verbal ones, I have explained. So it's now your duty to practice it very well in the grammar book, and make it sure that you won't get any type of the doubt. If you see the video properly, if you watch it very carefully, then definitely you don't get any type of the trouble. After watching the video or while watching the video, it's better to keep your study material and reader in front of you, then check it out, and you will find it very easy to draw and understand. So in the next class, we'll meet with the another explanation. So by the time, take care, have a nice day.